of course, we're celebrating all things theater, and we continue that theme tomorrow. Bend It Like Beckham, the musical, comes to town to celebrate. We have iconic chef Vikram Vidge in the building.
I'm just going to bow down.
Namaste, namaste.
So good to see you and smell this.
Any time of the day is a good day for Indian food.
Thank you. I'm so honored to be in Toronto again to cook and do this pop-up. We're going to be doing it at Novotel Hotel. And Chef Jordan has created these beautiful, beautiful dishes. And you're going to dance. You're going to enjoy this food. And I'm going to make alu gobi.
Now, that's in the movie.
That is in the movie. Do you remember when Jessie says to her mother, in a very strong British accent, I mean, I can't do that accent, but I can do an Indian accent. I can say, mother, anybody can cook alu gobi, but nobody can bend the ball like Beckham.
Awesome. This is such a brilliant partnership. So you're going to have this temporary pop-up restaurant at the Novotel, like you said, beginning tomorrow until January 5th. So people can come in. There's a 5:30 or 7 p.m. seating, four-course meal, and they are done and ready to go into the theater well-fed.
Well, exactly. So the idea is you come, you park your car, you enjoy, you know, a glass of wine with some food, some delicious food, and then you just walk over. Remember, food and music will solve the problems of the world.
Amen.
They really will. And what can people expect for the meals?
Well,
I mean, the lamb popsicles.
Yeah, the iconic.
Can I just shamelessly plug your restaurant? If you ever go to Vancouver, go to Vidge's. You've got to go and have a meal there. What will people expect when they go for their dinner?
Well, first of all, we're going to, you know, welcome them with the little papadums, and then the first course that they're going to have is the iconic Vidge's lamb popsicles.
Oh.
I want you to pick up the bones and eat it.
You
and
will.
Enjoy the flavors. And then we're going to give you a little soup and some family chicken curry. So comfort food, home style of food, cooked by Chef Jordan, who's a brilliant cook. And I really feel that that is the best way to spend holidays. You go, enjoy a good meal, go to a musical.
I mean, beautiful story, too.
An iconic movie.
Yeah.
You know,
such a beautiful movie. Especially when you have that fusion of music and movies, and then, of course, the food that is so heavily weaved inside, and it makes you crave it all, which is what we're doing right now. So this is a simple dish. You said anybody can make it home. It starts with, is it parboiled potato?
Exactly. So I just boil the potatoes a little bit, give them a little bit of a crispness. I add a little cinnamon, and I made a little masala beforehand.
Okay.
So, you know, just to give it a little bit of a creaminess to it.
But on the base of that, you had salt, pepper, and was it oil or butter?
Just a little bit of butter.
Okay.
Was that a little ghee?
Can I do this?
Yes.
Butter goes hand in hand with Indian food, doesn't it?
Well, of course. Ghee is one of the most classic ways of enjoying good Indian food. You know, I always say to people, have a little bit of ghee. Eat real food. When you eat real food, if nature intended to make something low-fat, it would have made it low-fat.
With the masala, how do you recommend people trying to put that together?
Just onions, ginger, garlic, tomatoes, cream, lots of Indian spices. And then also, when you're making this dish, make sure that you have a little bit of cauliflower that is already boiled slightly. And then you just throw it in there.
Because you don't want it mushy.
You don't want it mushy.
Just to take a little bit of the edge
off. Just to take the edge off. And the idea is after you've eaten this, I'm telling you this, the musical is so much fun. Because the two choreographers that have created unbelievable choreography on this in this play, you have to come and watch it.
So
Daniel Ezerlo, he was part of the Sochi Olympics.
Wow.
And Longinine Fernandez, who did that Jai Ho. Remember that song?
Yeah.
Slum Jai Ho,
Jai Ho by A.R. Rahman.
Yes.
He is also the choreographer in this. I mean, I am so looking forward that I will be here hanging out with people, and I'm sure I'll be dancing up a storm.
No doubt about it. So once you do this, Chef, what's the next step in all this?
Okay. So sorry.
It's okay.
Did I get it on you?
It's me.
Okay.
It's not you.
It's Indian food.
It's Murphy's Law.
Yeah. It's fine.
So once I've done the cauliflower potatoes, then you add a little bit of cilantro to it.
I love cilantro.
What's a good stock of Indian spices to have if you're thinking about trying to try this style of food? Because it's daunting a little bit.
It is. And you know what I always tell people? You have to start with something simple like alu gobi. Simple. Cauliflower, potatoes, have it with a little bit of rice, little lentils. Don't try to make the whole thing by yourself. I tell people, if you're going to cook a full course meal, you bring one dish, you bring one dish,
potluck.
I'll bring the vino, and we just hang out together.
Yeah. How about you bring all the dishes and we'll bring the vino?
Yeah. That sounds
like a much better idea,
Raj, because the lineups have been nonstop since he opened up his restaurant in Vancouver. You said that was the toughest part of leaving was the food.
Was getting up the food there.
But I am actually really looking forward to showcasing our cuisine in Toronto to the people so that they could come and enjoy it. And people say all the time, why do you open up a restaurant here? I'm like, well, just come and hang out here this
time.
Totally.
For more information, everybody, the pop-up runs from this Saturday, so tomorrow, to January 5th, in tandem with Bend It Like Beckham, the musical. Make sure you go visit everybody. The Novotel Cafe, Nicole. And for ticket holders, you get in and enjoy, and then enjoy the show.
It's beautiful.
That looks so good. Thank you so much, Chef. And have the best
time. Thank you very much, Chef.
Honored.
Let's head upstairs now to Mel.